The lazy keto diet is latest weight loss fad, but can it help you burn belly fat without the fuss? You may have heard of the keto diet, and maybe even considered trying it out. But if the thought of counting calories fills you with dread, then this will be music to your ears. Dubbed the lazy keto diet, it's a much simpler and easier version of the weight loss method loved by the likes of Kim Kardashian. No longer will you have to weigh food or meticulously track what you eat. Apparently, you can still reap the fat-burning rewards of going no-carb without all the fuss. Here's how. Keto made simple. Lazy keto is like the original plan, but you don't have to track your calories, according to health.com. The only rule is that you can only eat 20 grams of carbs a day. That's the equivalent of nearly an entire cauliflower, proving that not all of vegetables are equal in terms of carbs. It's almost impossible to eat 20 grams of carbs from spinach, for example. Not having to calculate your calories will save you time and energy. You'll still lose weight from reducing your sugar load, but it is worth saying that you probably won't shed body fat quite as fast as you would being on the standard keto plan. However, if you're looking for sustainable fat loss or to maintain a healthy body weight, then lazy keto probably is a better compromise. Cutting carbs for good may harm heart health. There have been plenty of studies in recent times suggesting that following a high-protein, low-carb diet isn't the healthiest plan, so you've got to ensure that you really fill up on as much green leafy veg as possible. Scientists have warned again and again that keto-like plans may damage heart health. So it's crucial that you do get all the nutrients that you need. The main issue lazy keto might throw up is eating too much protein and too little fiber because you're not actively tracking what you're eating. Burn fat, not carbs. By starving your body of readily accessible sugar, from carbs, the body reaches a state of ketosis, a normal metabolic process. It's where, in the absence of carbs for energy, the body burns fat instead, hence why it helps with weight loss. But, it can prove strict and a bit time-consuming counting calories obsessively. And it's definitely not good for anyone who has any history of disordered eating. Balance is key when it comes to diet. Concentrate on making sure that your plate ratio looks balanced. A general rule of thumb: make sure half of your plate is always taken up with green veg like broccoli, spinach and kale, which are high in vitamins, minerals and fiber and very low in calories. The rest of the plate is made up from lean proteins and healthy fats like oily fish, chicken, avocados, nuts and eggs. Keto doesn't mean going without fruit and veg, that's a common misconception. Low-carb/keto done correctly should be full of good gut-boosting foods, including fiber from the vegetables, nutritionist Sarah Flower previously told The Sun. Most people think of Atkins or just a diet of meat and fat when they hear low-carb or keto, but it is more Mediterranean-style, real food, vegetables, nuts, seeds, good healthy fats, oily fish, meat, dairy, nothing more than a real food diet, cutting out grains, sugars and all processed foods. You absolutely need fiber in your diet, it's just a case of getting that from natural sources rather than processed foods like white breads and pasta. But if you're going to cut out grains, then it's absolutely crucial to make sure that you're getting at least 5 portions of veg a day. What do you think? Let us know what you think below.